there is the one call.
And I remain with
you. See you next week.
Bye-bye.
Goodbye.
Hello, viewers. You're welcome to another wonderful edition of the Gender Chat Show. And I am Olumide Oyinbokure, and with me is...
My name is Adeze Wanko. Welcome to the show. It's good to have you guys behind the scene, Olumide.
Wow.
How are you?
I'm doing fine, and you?
I'm doing awesome.
Wow. I love your brooch.
Thank you.
You're welcome. And today, we'll be talking about a very important topic, and that is white-collar job, stifling creativity, and entrepreneurial skills.
Do you think white-collar job is stifling creativity? Do you think we are not encouraging people to venture out, learn new things, start their own businesses? Do you think money is an issue?
But the question is, if there are ideas, there should be some form of institutions you go to that can help you with capital, loans, and all that.
Are schools teaching
but how many of them are giving out these loans to these young entrepreneurs?
What about schools? Do they even teach entrepreneurship?
Well, I heard some time ago that they are trying to introduce entrepreneurial subjects into the
secondary
school
level.
Yeah.
What about the society? When you graduate and you say, you know what, I want to start my own business, I have this idea. The first thing they tell you is, no, job security, go and look for job in your pay and all that. You know, there's a sense among Nigerians that if you wake up in the morning, you're all suited and you go out there to work. That is what defines job, when you're working for somebody. But when you say, you know what, I have this idea, I'm looking for business partners that I can actually partner with, it's harder to get people to listen to you.
Now, to add to that job security, my question is, how safe is safe? How long do you intend to stay in someone else's job instead of stepping out, taking that giant step and starting your own thing?
And then there is a place of entrepreneurship. When you work for people, if you have ideas that could move their businesses forward. Do they pay you for such ideas? We have situations where management are afraid of, you know, you're heading a department, a subordinate gives you an idea.
Or the lower cadre.
They stifle it. They don't tell the higher management because they feel, if I tell them this, they are going to promote this guy over me. Or if I say it, they wouldn't recognize me as the boss. So it's either I say it and present it as my idea.
As my own idea.
Or I don't talk about it at all.
For it. Wow.
Quite interesting.
So all this and lots more are the issues we will be trashing out today on the Gender Chat Show. I still remain Olumide Oyinbokure.
I am Adeze Wanko. Please don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. Welcome back. It's to the Gender Chat Show, and we're discussing white-collar job. Is this stifling creativity and entrepreneurship? Joining me in the studio today to discuss this topical issue is Mr. Ayodot. So welcome to the show, please.
Thank you very much.
And also, we have NC Desmond.
Thank you.
Would you like to talk a bit about yourself and what you do as an entrepreneur?
Okay, like you said, I'm MC Desmond, and I'm the only MC with BSc, Bachelor in Stand-Up Comedy, MSc, Master in Stand-Up Comedy, and, you know, HIV, sorry, man, I don't do that. Anyway, I'm a comedian MC. I crack jokes to make, sane people laugh, you know.
Okay,
because sometimes when we are
talking,
that means we'll be having one or two jokes before we run up the program.
Well.
Wow.
You know, sometimes I always tell people, I don't force people to laugh, because sometimes people come to our show with a bigger problem.
Mm.
You can imagine someone that is here to pay our NEPA bills, you know, landlord is sending the person, and you want to crack juice and make that person laugh, my brother. You go try. That's how it goes. And besides, you know, I'm also a farmer, you know, entrepreneur.
Interesting.
That's wonderful.
That
farming.
Part, I don't really tell people, but then
Why farming is a good business.
That's my only occupation. Secret. I just a jolly body. You understand?
So good to have you.
So yeah,
to
have you. You guys
on our program,
I must confess.
And you look very good too.
Especially both of you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Yeah, Mr. Ayodotu is a project manager.
Yeah.
Sir, can you just tell us what it's all about?
Thank you. My name is Ayodotu Afolami. I, like you rightly said, I'm a project manager.
I manage projects from start to finish, and I specialize in conceptualizing what needs to be done to deliver the project. So basically, I'm a project manager. I've been doing that for almost 7 years now.
Wow.
And I'm a certified project manager, basically.
That's interesting. Share your experience. When you decided to, do you work for yourself or do you work for somebody?
Yes, I work with a company.
You work with a company?
Yes.
And let's say an entrepreneur or someone who just graduated come to you for a project and then he or she wants to start up a business.
Yeah.
Most of the time, what we have in Nigeria is work for someone first. You have this idea of white collar job. What's your advice? What, share your experience when it comes to managing projects with people who
my
have
experience. Well, I need to say I came from an engineering background.
Okay.
So and now I am managing IT projects.
Okay.
So what I want to say about encouraging young people is that you need to know where you belong. You need to know your skills. You need to know what you really want to do, right? It starts from understanding yourself. Right back on campus, doing my mechanical engineering courses and all of those, I'd always known that I'm not going to do engineering.
Oh, yeah.
Right? So I was looking for the balance between the engineering that I did on campus and the management course. So along the line, I went to IT, along the line I came out, but somehow I came across project management that seems to blend my engineering skills and the management that I wanted to do. So I started taking courses in that, I started taking, courses, training in that, and I read up to really know what I'm, because it's a competitive environment, you know, you've got people that are doing the same thing you want to do, so you want to be top notch, you want to know what you're doing and be able to deliver, you know, at the same time. So my advice to young people, yes, it's okay to seek, you know, the white collar job, okay, but then you must keep your vision of wanting to be an entrepreneur in place, or else you could be swept up, you could be swept off, you know, in that. So you want to focus on your vision and why you still pursue that. It gives you some time to balance, it gives you some time to stabilize, it gives you some time to know how it needs to be done. You want to see how other people are doing it, so that with time you can venture out,
so,
you know, and
it can be likened to sort of formal training.
Formal training, while you are getting paid for that.
MC Desmond, a whole lot of Nigerians are talented. My makeup artist, the cameraman here, as in the crew here, they are mostly graduates. And those are things you don't learn in school.
Yeah.
Those are talents and skills you have to be interested in. So for you as an MC, you didn't go to school to learn.
Of course, I don't believe that white collar job is actually stagnating the creativity and knowledge and the entrepreneurial skills. Don't believe that.
Okay.
But what I think is, I think people are not informed. They don't really know what exactly they need to do to earn more income.
Okay.
Now, I'm a pragmatic person.
You know how?
Yeah, I'm a pragmatic person. I will just give you a little analysis now. An average Nigerian civil workers, I think level 12, etc., they earn like 60,000 here in Nigeria.
Okay.
If you are going to divide that by 30, that is 2,000 naira per day. Am I right?
Mm.
That person that is hawking pure water, etc., in city earns more than that. Do you know that?
Yeah.
I'm telling you.
Now, another thing is, a fresh graduate in Nigeria here, you earn like 120,000 naira. Am I right?
Yeah.
Now, in any banks, if you have opportunity to work in a bank.
Okay.
Now, if you divide that by 30, that is 4,000 naira. Your work value per day is 4,000 naira. Now, I'm telling you, a driver in Lagos City here earns more than that. A taxi driver earns more than that in a day.
Oh,
you can see that. Now, lastly, if you are opportune, you know, to see a job, a fresh graduate, to see a job in an oil company, probably you earn 300,000 naira. If you divide that by 30, that is 10,000 naira in a day, your work value. Now, a truck driver or a farmer that is distributing pigs just like me. supplying pigs earns more than that in a day.
Wow.
So this is what people don't know.
Yeah.
And the most worst part of it is that the NYSC people now, the last I checked, I think 19,800 naira, which is 660 naira per day. I can't imagine it. That boy that is selling
that is selling pure water and pepper soup joint.
Anyone
for Corolla that is distributing eggs. Hence, more than that. And if you have a problem in your family, a financial problem, all of them will be counting on that person that
is working in the bank or in the oil company, and they negate you.
You can imagine.
Not anymore.
So if you can, do your visibility studies, you can do your cost benefit and analysis, you will know that if you're working in a bank, it's just for a short period of time.
Yeah.
I'm not condemning it.
Yeah.
So when you acquire enough funds that you can start up your own business.
What about access to capital?
I'm a Christian, so I do say this once in a while. You know, I'm a Christian. I love God. You know. Yeah, and
I love God.
I realize that even Jesus Christ didn't wait until he has the whole thing.
Yeah.
He started with, I think, 2 fishes and 5 loaves of bread. You can imagine.
Yeah.
And he fed 5,000 people. So you don't wait till you have the whole resources. Then you start your own. Now, having the concept of what you want to do on your mind is not enough. You have to also go and research and know how to get to the interested clients. Otherwise, you will regret being an entrepreneur. I hope you understand what I'm talking about.
Yeah, yeah.
So that is why I always say that it is still learning, education. You still need to acquire information, because if you're not informed, you'll be deformed. So I experienced some challenges when I wanted to start alone. I thank God I met some of my senior colleagues. I met Bengare Inka the first. He advised me. And I met Basot Taria the first.
Wow.
He advised
nice
me. So my brother, no be smart. That's why I love you buy something for market again. So I met these people. They inspired me and they told me what and what to do.
Okay.
So I put those things in practicals and I started doing them. And before I knew what was happening, you know, I will go to an event now, I will talk for just 4 hours, 5 hours, and
I will
start my account.
Wow.
Maybe 300,000 or 400,000 are already in my account. And that is just four to 5 hours.
Are you serious?
I will speak. And that's all.
Wow.
But when I started, my brother, I must confess to you, I used to collect 5,000 to anchor a wedding, 10,000 to anchor a wedding.
Yeah.
But it's a gradual process. At that time, it's very hard for me as a graduate to cope. I can't, but now I think I bless God. The challenges are there, but then you have to overcome and be strong.
That's good. Mr. Ayotinda Folami, how long should someone wait in a job before he or she sets out to set up?
If you have a passion for being an entrepreneur,
How long
is not the question, really?
Okay.
Should be the question.
Oh.
My friend here was talking about, you know, getting to know. I think if I may summarize that, there are three important things.
Okay,
your vision must be in place.
Mm.
I've got a vision for this. I've got a vision to be the next Dangote. I've got a vision to be the next. Because sincerely, you know, that aside, we need to start encouraging our people.
Yes.
We need to start encouraging, you know, my colleagues here. We need to start, you know, the awareness needs to go out.
Education
is key. I was going to talk about that, you know, that's the second point. Your vision must be in place. The knowledge is key. You need to start reading. And you must have in mind that what you're doing may not be the first. Okay, your product may be new in town, but there's a way someone, the Facebooks of this world, the Apple of this world, the Dangote of this world, you know, the Otedolas, there's a way they started out. You want to read about them. And those informations, they are free online. You know, just do Google.
Yeah.
You know, you can't separate, you know, being a successful entrepreneur from reading, from knowledge, or else you're going to be frustrated.
So you need to arm yourself with knowledge.
Yes, because the information you need for your business may just be next door. May just be next door.
Yeah.
And you need to know to access that. Okay? Now, yes, I'm aware that to get, you know, funds, facilities for your business could be tight, but you need to know. Now, the third point is your passion. That passion must be there. Okay? Because, like you said, there'll be challenges, there'll be, you know, tough times, but you need your passion to keep you going in those times, to carry on at that time. Okay? Those three things are very key. And until when those are there, you know, then you're good to go.
Let's go quickly on a short
break. Yeah.
But please don't go anywhere.
Stay tuned.
Right.
Welcome back. We've been discussing entrepreneurship, skills acquisition. Do you think white-collar job is stifling innovation and creativity? The last I heard about entrepreneurship in school, especially in secondary school. We are talking about teaching people small skill acquisition of cloth making, clothing, how to be a fashion designer, small shops, cake decoration, and all that. Do we practicalize that in our secondary schools? Are they practicalized on? It's all about, let's just say we change the curriculum.
I think the standard is not really there. Let me be sincere. What we do, okay, we did that in economics, you know, start doing puff puff. All we did there was we
took those two exams. They don't teach us the business side of what we're
doing. They teach us the business aspect of it. Now, if it's that puff puff, like in Nigeria used to pronounce it, is that thing you know how to do, then you should now think of a better way or how to apply different things.
Packaging.
How do you package it? I said you can package it. So is that packaging that people are buying, not even the you know, I according to my research, I got to realize that even all the fast food we have now, they started selling their donuts and their snacks. They you just go there, they sell it to them, you go. Then somebody came in with an idea that, okay, fine, when they come in, can't I just tell them to sit down in a very calm, cool place, then give them drink at the same time, let them take it. That's the packaging.
Yes. Now the drinks you pay extra.
The drinks you are supposed to buy at the rate of 100 naira before, now you pay 200 naira.
Exactly.
And then you sit doing like, I'm enjoying. So yeah, it's the packaging. So if we can acquire those knowledge, then good.
Yeah.
So, Mr. Idina Afolami, what advice would you give to aspiring entrepreneurs?
My advice to them is simple. I've said it earlier, I will say it again, and because it seems to be the crux of what we're talking about, knowledge. Now, even if you're going to package, okay, you need to pack it to suit me, okay?
Yes.
In other words, you must know what I want.
Exactly.
And I'm one of a million, you know, customers outside of. So you need to know. And again, that comes from knowledge. You may not be able to meet everybody one-on-one, but you need to get to know what, you know, there's something they call customer behavior.
Yeah.
How do they behave to this? When it comes to food or fashion or agriculture or IT. WhatsApp was not here some 2 years ago.
Came
and swept off, you know, BlackBerry, you know. Somebody must have seen maybe all of these, what do you call it, a BBM number, BBM Chinese. You know, just knocks that off. I'm able to, with my number, you can add me. That's somebody thinking, and it's a function of knowledge too. My advice for young people coming up is this: you must know. Now, again, you know, let me just quickly mention the top the topic for now. We're saying is white collar job, you know, stagnating, you know, creativity. I say no. Okay, because it could be the avenue for you to really think and be and brood over your own idea, so that by the time you spend some time where you're working, you can launch out and go. Rather, what I'll say is stagnating. You know, our entrepreneurship skills here is the environment. The environment. You know, you want to go into manufacturing, for example, is power supporting you?
Exactly.
Are you able to transport your goods from point A to point B?
To the market.
Okay?
Yeah.
You know, what happens between that time when you should have turned over your money or your capital and you are waiting for power, you know, and you know, those are the issues we need to address. And again, we cannot leave that to government alone. We need to start talking about it. We need to start, you know, making people aware. Are you aware that we can begin to share power? Okay, you see a company, you know, the generator is just on, powering 4 ACs, and it can do better than that. Okay, why not 2 companies or 3 companies maybe coming together, and you share, begin to share that. Okay, until we begin to do that, to begin to encourage our people, that'd be my
concern.
The place of entrepreneurship.
Right.
In places where you work, say, in an oil company, and you have an idea that could be profitable to the organization, maybe as a cleaner.
Okay.
Do management see reasons to, say, buy ideas from the lower cadre people, the non-professional staff? And do they pay them their due for such ideas that could be profitable? I had a company in America. They had an issue. They were contemplating having a stairway that would take them to like the 7th or 8th building, and they were really after the building was already done, so they were really thinking of what to do. And a cleaner just had it, was like, oh, you could construct a lift this way. Do we pay for such rights. Yeah. Because it's the person's intelligence, the idea, yeah, the creativity, the innovation. Do we acknowledge that here, the entrepreneurship within a company?
That may not be a popular practice around here.
Okay.
But I'm aware that some organizations, especially the multinationals, they begin to promote that.
Mm-hmm.
Where you have what you call a suggestion box or an idea box.
An idea box.
People can drop their ideas. We see, for every strategy they want to, deliver or pursue in an organization, mm-hmm. they make it open. These are goals for, this period. And it's okay, come on, drop your ideas. And they pay people for that.
Uh-huh.
Okay? And, and they could begin to, build on that. Oh, if Ayodotsu can bring this idea, this value, rather than doing what he's doing now, let him join that so that we can, tap more from him, mm-hmm. really. So I think people are beginning to promote value with those ideas because, it's the way to go.
You see, what I actually think is this. I think Nigerians generally in the diaspora need to learn and understand that we don't need to underestimate anybody or any idea any longer.
Yeah.
Now, what we always do is this, once the idea is not coming from a big
educated person, it's all with a certificate.
I'm telling you, we seem to ignore the idea. Mm. Now, a friend of mine got an idea years back. He was trapped in an elevator.
Okay.
And he has no call card on his phone.
Hmm.
And he was like, I can borrow money from network provider. I can just call somebody to come and please on the elevator so that I can get up from here. He sold the idea to a particular telecommunication I don't want to mention here.
Yeah.
Hmm.
And it was being ignored. Now, that is the same idea
that
we are using now.
Yeah. Yeah.
Maybe somebody...
Is that an idea theft? Do you think somebody ignored it and sold it later to someone else?
Well, what actually happened there, we don't know. But then he tried to consult his lawyer and they were trying to, but there are some people you cannot fire.
Mm.
Like Yoruba used to say something So once they are bigger than you, there's nothing you can do about it. You've got no choice.
A quick one. You may not be able to trap down your ideas or trap down idea because it keeps flying. Because what's going in my mind could be the same thing going in, Jide's mind or Doctor's mind.
So
the quick can you are able to register your idea, appear with them better for you.
Yes.
So we need to begin to promote ideas and get those registered and put in
for. Wow.
Yeah.
So MC Desmond, how lucrative is farming?
Farm business, well, the aspect I focus on is piggery.
That's interesting. Why piggery?
Yeah, because
is there any reason why you want to piggery?
No matter how many pigs you rear, you can never meet the demand. So we can't meet the demand. They come from outside the country to buy our pigs. And the farm I am there is the largest piggery farm in West Africa.
Wow, so I'll start. I was just going to
I was doing this before, but it's not really lucrative.
Wow, thank you so much.
Because mortality rate there is higher. But unlike pigs, mortality rate very low.
It's been nice having you guys on the show. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Okay, viewers, we'd like to go to the streets to hear people's opinion on this topic. We'll be right back. Don't go nowhere.
So to my own respect and the way things are going in the society today, we see that there is not much of that white collar job in the environment again. So it is better for people to go more into creating jobs for themselves and even go to the extent of being the ones that are employing, not waiting for white collar job today. Today in Nigeria, we have multitude of graduates coming out yearly and definitely the industries are not there. The works are not readily available. So in order to bridge that gap, people need to move from being seeking employment to people that create employment. So that's my own view as regards to people waiting for white collar job.
White collar job is supposed to be the dream of every graduate, yeah? But then, these days they're not really helping. I'll take, for example, the economy now. Things went up. Every businessman added a little something. But the salaries are still same. You understand? And they're not helping generally. Because, for example, if I'm doing a white collar job now, I might be earning, say, for level 8, I can be earning, if the federal job, I can be like 80,000 or thereabouts. But someone doing business makes, let's say, same amount or thereabouts in a month, and this economy is now bad, the amount I spend in a month might have increased from, say, 30 to about 30, 45 or thereabouts, and I'm still making same money. The businessman would have increased his price and everything, and then his profit would have gone up. So he's maintaining himself while we are the same. Yeah, so really, it's not that appreciable these days, considering the economy. Yes, yes, that.
Welcome back. It's been quite interesting hearing what people think about entrepreneurship and white collar.
You know,
I never knew it's not just about the fact that we want to work in a white collar job. I think it's just the information Nigerians need, yeah?
People need to arm themselves with information,
yeah.
The right information.
Access to fund, the capital, the resilience,
passion, the knowledge.
You need to research about your market, what people want, and exactly the fact that
sampling people's opinion.
Yeah, people have solutions. They keep it to themselves without even knowing what to do with the information they have.
Waiting for a later time. I don't understand.
Well, you think...
Come to think of it, I think I like what MC Desmond said. I might go into Piggy one of these days. What do you think?
Good business, yeah?
I mean,
good business.
I'm thinking entrepreneur.
Extra pain, extra money. It makes a whole lot of sense.
Wow. Olumide. I'm telling you.
But then what can government do? Those were aspects we were looking into.
Yeah.
Small-scale businesses, how can they get access to loans? If they can make it easier. There are a lot of people with innovation and creativity.
Ideas
there are people
there.
Who want to do something, but they are too scared to venture out because they feel they are small savings. If they use it for this, they are not sure if they are going to get back their returns.
If the government is able to give them easy access to loans.
And banks.
And banks, too. Yeah. Are they helping matters? I don't know. A lot more needs to be done about this issue.
It's been fun hanging out with you. Please feel free to send in your suggestions and comments. My name is Adezo Wanko. See you same time, same station.
And I remain Olumide Imbokure. Bye-bye.
Goodbye.